Right then at the trainer.
Like, nobody's been able to beat Mayweather. If you were to fight him, what do you think is the key to beating him? He's a, you know, hasn't lost his
fights. What do you think it would take?
Hey, I don't know. Maybe I'll fight him like Madonna, but more stuff. Knee him some more, elbow him some more, bite him some more. Just get the whole.
My good work.
4 hours ago, and you won't believe who I just ran into. Hey, Stella Inger, world famous news anchor. How you feeling?
Thank you. What a great introduction.
Well, you know, every time I come to the airport, I see famous people. I just saw Mike Tyson and George Lopez recently, and now I see you. 24 hours ago, at the exact same spot, Manny Pacquiao landed. He's kicking off his training camp. What do you think?
Well, it's exciting because the fight is, what, like 60 days away?
Exactly.
He is at, like, what, 142 now? Usually he fights at 147, so he's going to need to put on some weight. I think 5 pounds, 6 pounds, I think that should be easy for him. But I'm really excited that he's here. Huge Manny Pacquiao fan, so I'm glad that he's getting things rolling.
He actually started his camp a week early.
Dedication. That's why I love him so much. That's why I'm such a huge fan. I've been waiting for this fight for so many years. And, you know, you got to take this serious. It's a big fight.
Oh, how come nobody's been able to beat Floyd Money Mayweather?
Hey, man, he's the Money Mayweather. That's the deal, man. Floyd is the man. Let me tell you something. The boxing is one of those things that you got to fight, you know, for your money. And Floyd knows what he's doing.
Superstar LeBron James is a big fan of Manny Pacquiao. I caught up with him.
You know, and it's hard to bet against him. You know, he's definitely one of the fastest, quickest guys that we have in boxing today. Either, and you never know in a boxing match, all it takes one punch.
So the fight game, they love it in Canada. Manny Pacquiao.
You know what? First of all, I want to go to the fight. Second of all, what do I think? What do you mean, who do I think is going to win?
Absolutely. I think we both know how.
I hate to admit, I don't want to take sides, but I have to, don't I?
So you a boxing fan by any chance?
A little bit, yeah.
Who's your favorite fighter?
I guess right now it'd be Floyd Mayweather. You know, he's the most exciting fighter right now, pound for pound. He's undefeated, very confident. And he takes all comers. I just would like to see him fight Pacquiao and just put all of that to rest.
Who wins that one?
I have no idea. That's why I want to see it. That's why I'm so intrigued. Styles make fights, but you just never know.
Do you watch boxing at all? Mayweather, Pacquiao?
Of course, everybody knows Mayweather and Pacquiao.
So who do you like?
I've always stood by Pacquiao.
Why?
Always. And I'm starting to wonder if Mayweather would take the cake.
You know what? Anything can be accomplished through hard work and dedication.
Like Floyd Mayweather said.
Time. You know, I go to all of the Floyd fights in the off season. I'm a big supporter.
Who fights Pacquiao? What do you think about that?
I'll never go against Floyd. Never.
TBE.
Never go against him.
He's just probably one of the best boxers I've ever seen. I really do. I put him in the same categories like Sugar Ray Leonard. I think he hits so hard from so many awkward, from all these different angles, and he's so accurate. It's like every other punch lands solid. You know.
Mayweather.
Why?
Mayweather. You know, Mayweather's just a phenomenal champion. He really is. Don't always agree with his personal life, but you know, he seems like he's maturing a lot and being more about the people and trying to get back and things like that. And he's a phenomenal champion. You know, he's won so many fights, and I know how it is to be a champion. So to see someone who's done it on such a higher level than I have already, it's something to admire. It's something to respect a lot. So shout out to him. Hey,
John, do you?
I just have, I'd probably say Pacquiao all day. You know, I mean, that's family. So yeah.
Hey, there's a guy named Manny Pacquiao.
I know Manny Pacquiao.
We both have eye.
Pacquiao.
Why? Why do you like Pacquiao so much? You met him.
Well, you know, I just think that he gets it done. He gets it done. And I know a lot of people thought his last fight, because he has so much going on, he wasn't gonna fight well. But I think that he brings the eye of the tiger. You can tell when the boxers come out. I'm telling you right now, this is foolproof. If you're in Vegas, you can put money down on it. Look at the eyes when they first come out. If you got the eye of the tiger, man, it's going down.
Can I see your eye of the tiger?
Wait, that's a different tiger. Wait, let me give it to you again. Here I come.
It's all for the fame.
I caught up with NFL legend Willie McGinnis, who tells me Mayweather beats Pacquiao.
Boxing, Mayweather or Pacquiao, who do you like?
Mayweather.
Why?
Well, I just think he's polished. I think he's fast. I think, you know, when I look at those two fighters, I know they both have offense and they can strike, but I look at who has the best defense. And Pacquiao takes a lot of punches. And I think, you know, Mayweather's mastered the art of defending himself and not getting hit and being elusive.
I'm here with Rob Schneider.
If Manny Pacquiao's watching, any message for him?
But anyway, Pacquiao, you can do it, Pacquiao. Take care, man.
Taylor on the right, please.
Taylor, those eyes right in front of you, please.
Taylor, can you move it to the center, please?
Yeah, right there.
Yeah, right there.
Okay.
One over here, please. Thank you.
And straight ahead, Taylor, straight ahead, please.
Taylor, straight ahead. Up top, up top.
And right here. And one more straight ahead, please.
And one more time, please.
Taylor, really quick, why are you a fan of Manny Pacquiao? What is it about Manny that brought you here tonight?
He has an amazing presence. He's actually unbelievable. I feel like there's so many people that follow him and worship him as an amazing inspiration and somebody that stands up for freedom and somebody that people can watch and be inspired by. So I'm so honored to be here, and I think he's an incredible fighter and someone that, you know, you can really look up to and say, like, that's the guy that I'm rooting for, you know? Like, everyone in the Philippines love him. Why? Because he's an amazing person that stands up for who he is, and he's a symbol of freedom and hope, so I think it's really awesome.
A lot of talk of him fighting Floyd Money Mayweather. What do you think of the fight?
Oh, God, I don't even know. It's a tough fight. My dad would tell me that you can't really tell who's going to win, so I'm just going to say that he's going to win and everything's going to be okay.
That's the trainer.
Oh, is it? We can chance it. We'll go grab inside.
Sean Murray, former NFL superstar for San Diego. You had an incredible life story. What words of encouragement do you have for someone who's going through a rough time right now based on your experience?
You know, just like never give up. You know, people sometimes think of a bad situation is going to like last forever, and they don't. They never do. And people get caught up in like what's going on. They just think like that's the end of the world, and it's not. So as long as you know like it's going to be brighter at the end of the tunnel, like you shouldn't, you know, worry too much. much about what's going on right now. Just try to get through it the best you can. Just keep going.
I know you're a big fan of MMA and boxing. Who are your favorite fighters, MMA and boxing?
I'm obviously a big Floyd Mayweather fan, but I've been watching like what Canelo's been doing lately and getting his rise back to the top. Miguel Cotto, since he switched up trainers, obviously, you know, he's working with Freddie Roach. He's looking damn good right now. Wish he had him, you know, 5 or 10 years ago, but, you know, it's never too late. So it's just a bunch of boxers look pretty good right now.
So right here, straight at, wait. Okay, and straight ahead, please, right here. Right in front.
Together on your left side. And just one more time, man. Just a little closer.
Ariana, really quick. You're the face of UFC. What's it like to be here tonight and support Manny Pacquiao?
You know, Manny Pacquiao is one of the best in the business. I love boxing. I love fighting in general, so I'm really excited to be here and support him. I know it's going to be amazing to see what his life is like outside of boxing.
You're more famous than most UFC superstars. How do you handle all the success and the fame?
I'm just a normal person. I just am very lucky, and I take everything as a blessing, and I'm very happy to be here.
Mayweather Pacquiao, your prediction?
Pacquiao, I can't wait to see it. Hopefully it'll happen sometime soon.
What do you wish Manny, if he's watching?
Continued success, many blessings, and love.
A message to your fans who love you?
Thank you to everyone who loves me and supports me. Watch out for me on Overhauling and MTV Guy Code, and of course UFC. I love you guys.
Thank you. Thanks.
Thank you.
Hey, champ.
Ray, straight ahead, please.
Thank you. I'm great. How are you? Good to see you. I missed you in New York.
Yeah, yeah.
How you doing, man?
Yeah,
I know last time we talked, you told me you're a huge Pacquiao fan.
Oh, yeah.
What do you say about that?
Go Pacquiao, but, you know, obviously I won't be able to be there to watch, but, you know, we'll see if the timing works out.
We're here with Ekpe Udoh and Reggie Williams of the NBA. We're here checking out Manny's training. They're at the house right now, actually, before Bible study. So we got to ask you, who's going to win if Mayweather and Manny?
That's a good question. Right now I got to answer. You know, I think it'll come down to who's in the best of shape.
And when did you become a fan of Manny? When did you become a fan?
Man, he started boxing them up. He's been boxing the folks up for a minute, man. I mean, everybody, people, Mayweather fight, he fights them and boxes them up like it's never. I mean, throws 1,000+ punches, man. He's doing it, so. Gotta respect his hustle on this grind.
I'm good. How are you guys doing?
Good. I'm good, Rob. Nice to meet you.
Hey, Rob. All right. What do you think about that? Mayweather Pacquiao next May.
Still Floyd. Still Floyd. Can't be beat.
Easy or hard?
It's easy. Yeah, I feel like, you know, the just the technique, the speed, you know, he has no L's, and I don't see it happening.
Hey, Jeff.
Oh, my God. How you doing, buddy? Always good to see you.
How you doing?
We're saying this is a first for you, the red carpet.
Oh, we're
down here, right?
Oh, I've been on red carpet, you know, in the past, but I've never been on my own red carpet that's this big. Yeah, I mean, it's a remarkable turnout. A lot of great people showed up. You know, I'm happy. May 2nd, the fight of the century. What else can I say?
You know, we're used to seeing you come to the Clipper games and the Laker games, but now it's everybody's turn to come see you in action.
Yes, it's a huge fight. You know, hopefully, you know, I done record-breaking numbers with the Oscar De La Hoya fight. Then me and Canelo, we broke the Oscar fight. So, you know, I keep my fingers crossed. You know, I want everybody to tune in May 2nd because, you know, it's going to be hard to get a ticket to this fight.
What is your level of excitement and or anticipation?
I'm just patient. Just patiently waiting. In the gym working. My team. You know, I take my hat off to my team. They, you know, they've done a great job. They even, you know, my publicist, Kelly Swanson, you know, I had the top publicist from L.A. to New York that wanted to work with me over 15 years ago, but I wanted to work with a certain publicist, Kelly Swanson, you know, a lady, she was loyal. And, you know, when I went away and done a little time, she wrote me letters every day. So, you know, That's loyalty. So, you know, I'm happy with my team, Leonard, Elliott. You know, we had bumps and bruises, but we still going strong. And Al Haney has been like a, you know, a father figure. And, you know, us just being together as a team is what keeps me striving and working hard and keeps me winning.
Why does it seem like there's so much animosity between the two camps?
Oh, I'm not. You know, I don't play those back and forth games with, you know, with, you know, the trainers and the managers. You know, I got here somehow, some way. And every time, every 47 times, they put a guy in front of me, I went out there and done what I had to do. I can't overlook this guy. He's not a pushover. But he must realize I'm not a pushover either. So, camps are going to say what they want to say. But it comes down to the two fighters. That's what it's about.
Floyd, all anyone's going to talk about fans is how expensive this fight is. How much money, right? The money. How expensive a room is.
Yes.
You know, yes. A ticket. What do you have to say to them about that?
I mean, Floyd Money Mayweather.
Oh, who?
They have to pay. They have to pay. I'm just playing, but I mean, this is the biggest fight in the history of the sport. You know, so, if you want to see the two best fighters in this area, you have to pay to see them.
And you're good for the economy.
I think so.
You should talk about your red carpet look. Since we're on a red carpet, what the heck? This is like the Oscars.
Well, to me, it's the Oscars.
That's what I said.
It's the Mayweather Pacquiao Oscars. I feel good. I'm happy. And May 2nd, it's a huge fight. Man, I'm gonna be in tip-top shape.
Well, there are people like my mom who know nothing about boxing, but now know your name because of this fight. What is it like to be a part of that?
If your mom live in Las Vegas, she know my name.
Manny said the margarita.
Do you want to give a message to Las Vegas?
First of all, how does it feel having your own movie here? How do you feel having all these people here about this in your life on the big screen?
Mommy
I'm happy and excited. I'm sure this movie is going to be will give inspiration to the fans. Out of all the fights you have, Manny, which one of the things that warm your head? I ask everybody, some people say Han, some people say De La Hoya. Which one is the fight that you remember the most?
Remember the most, man. Not only one fight, but there's a lot. De La Hoya, Cotto, Hatton, Barrera, Morales, Marquez. There's a lot of fights.
When you see those fighters, do you still talk to them normally? Are you guys friends at all?
How do you feel about being a promoter, that's the problem.
Bob Arum said it's not your fault. What do you have to say about that?
Me and my promoter, there's no problem. We agreed already about the terms and conditions. We just signed the contract and the fight will be.
I know he called you one time on the phone. We should call him again to get this fight made, Manny, because all the fans want to see it.
I'm always waiting for the signed contract. All he need to do is decide the fight.
Are you think it's gonna happen, Manny? In your heart, do you think the fight happens? Do you think the fight happens in your heart when you think about it? Do you think the fight's finally gonna happen?
If that happens, it'll happen. If not,
will you try again, or this is it? If it doesn't happen now, you move on, or will you try again if possible?
Well, we have limited time for this negotiation.
And will you train in the wild card for your next fight, regardless of who you fight?
It depends if the fight here or in the other country.
Okay. And would you fight Ronnie if he came out of retirement?
Manny!
Thank you, Manny.
The huge Manny Pacquiao fan, and I caught up with her.
I gotta ask you this.
Uh-huh.
Manny Pacquiao or Floyd Mayweather?
Oh, come on. Pac-Man. Pacquiao all the way.
Why?
Because, you know, he's a great athlete. You know what I mean? He helps out his country. He's just, and the fact that he sings too, sings karaoke every single time after a fight, I think that's awesome.
in The Hangover Part 2. Tell me about that experience for you.
Really fun. The cool part was I met Yasmin Lee. Yasmin Lee is, she's really nice, and she has, okay, let me clear things up. People think that I'm Yasmin Lee, you know, the girl, the transvestite. No, I'm Kim Lee, and Yasmin Lee's different. So let me just clear that up real quick. So
do not get confused.
Yeah, don't get confused. Big difference here.
And how many Filipinos live in Hawaii?
Nearly 300,000.
And how many would show up if Manny Pacquiao fought?
Maybe 300,000. More. Plus the rest of the island, the Samoans, the Hawaiians, everybody. Man, he's too strong. Too strong.
I'm here with Chris Kennedy. He's Filipino, and he's a huge fan of Floyd Mayweather.
Filipinos hate me because of that.
So, Chris, first of all, are you okay? Do you need security? Because it's a serious topic, man. You're like touching on nerves. Like, Manny's a national hero.
Right.
How did you become such a big Mayweather fan? Because his boxing, because his ability, because his swag?
I think more because of his boxing ability, just because he's just in his defense. It's second to none, big time. I mean, people love or hate him, but I mean, people don't really get to know the true him. Of course, I don't know the true him and how he is, but as a boxer and the interviews I've seen, YouTube, his fights, I don't know. I just like.
People don't know this, but Mayweather's actually a real, real good person away from the limelight. Like, besides the personality, as a person, he's a great person. But I will say this, Mayweather Pacquiao, who wins?
Mayweather.
How many rounds?
Style. I'd say 8 or 9.
Is this blasphemy in your own house when you say that? When you guys sit around, there's a Pacquiao fight on and you're watching it with your friends and family? What did they tell you? It's 1 against 100?
Hey, like, what are you talking about? What are you drinking? And I don't know. And the thing is, I train at Wildcard, and I'm a big Pacquiao fan. I know his training crew and all that.
And do they know your opinions?
No.
Not yet. After today, they will. So what would you tell Floyd if he's watching?
If Floyd, I don't know if you met another Filipino like me, as myself, who's a big fan of you. I am a huge fan of you, though, man. I love you, what you've done for the sport of boxing. Back since 2001, 2002, 2000, your amateur career, the Olympics. I'm just a huge fan, and I don't know if you've been approached by another Filipino who's a fan like this. I hope you have, but I'm one of them. So.
I know of 3. 2 in Vegas and you, so that's it.
But I'm probably the only one in LA, and actually, I'm from New York. That's from my hometown, so everybody over there, Filipinos, big Pacquiao fans.
Like this, I'll be a picking and a poking, pouring water on Joe Smoking. It may sound amnesia, the whipping I'ma give to a Joe Frazier. They say Joe Frazier awful strong.
This is Muhammad Ali.
Band roll on.
This is Muhammad Ali.
Check it out.
Okay, let me ask you guys. Okay, you're a comedian, right?
Yes.
If you have to call out one comedian to get him in the ring and knock him the F out, who do you go for?
Cat Williams.
Cat Williams, right?
I wouldn't do Cat. That's my boy.
He's too little.
And that's my boy, too.
Eddie Griffin.
No, Speedy. This nigga named Speedy. I want that nigga. That nigga tried to clown me in the club, call me Blade. If I see that nigga in the street, it's on.
If I would call out one comedian, it'd be Peanut. I'm knocking Peanut out. Next time he say something, he was talking about mama and it made me cry. No. I was talking about mama again.
I'm cool with Cat. I love you, Cat Williams. I love you.
But I don't like you, Peanut. They kicked you out of New Orleans.
Why?
They kicked you out of Louisiana. No, Peanut's my boy. He's a convict. I'm just clowning. My boy, Bubba Loke, I'm a comedian. I get along with all comedians. You know what? Because the whole thing about knocking us out, knock you out on the stage. What you do, I call it DTS. Destroy the stage.
Okay, hold on. Lewis, hold this for a second.
Yeah.
Hurricane, if you have to clown me, what would you go for?
You already called yourself a scumbag.
Small ass
hat.
You
clowned yourself already.
That screw on hat you got on.
Hey, you look like a broke down Bruce Willis. Nah, you cool though, homie, but you got a purse on. That's a purse. Like that's Chucky. A man purse. He got that Chucky. Shit like it's a backpack. That's really a purse.
Mayweather has the same backpack.
With too much shit. If you need a backpack, motherfucker, you damn near a woman.
He keep $1 million in his backpack, though.
Yeah.
You got $1 million in that backpack.
I got a picture of Floyd in my backpack.
If I got $1 million, it'll be in my pocket because I can't walk around with a bitch ass backpack. That's bitch shit. Oh, I'm sorry. You got one too. I'm
a bullshit. Mine's different though.
Yeah, that's a real backpack.
I got a picture of
Floyd Money Mayweather.
And Mandela?
Floyd Money Mayweather, man. When you looking at that, man, check it out. Floyd, man, the Comedy Convicts want to promote you, bro. We want you to come on there, man.
We
look for the Comedy
Convicts.
We just
need for you to send us $100,000.
That's it. We got AJ Johnson, man. He gonna be the.
And I remember my husband took me to my first boxing match. It was a Mike Tyson, Buster Douglas.
Oh, wow.
And I have never in my life felt so much energy in a room, ever. He kept saying, "You will go. When you feel the energy," I'm like, "Yeah, yeah, whatever, whatever." But the room, I can't think of another sport that has that kind of tangible energy. So I love that Ray is doing that and making it into a charity element.
What do you think of Floyd Mayweather as a fighter? The number one fighter in the sport right now. Everybody knows him. What do you think about him as a fighter?
I don't know about him as a fighter, but every time I turn on any sporting event, that cat turns up like, "Where's Waldo?" I mean, the NBA Finals, you name it, he is everywhere. Final Four, Kentucky Derby, Preakness. Every time I turn around, I see him. No, he's exciting, and he's great for the sport.
Christina, on the right, please.
Over that shoulder, Christina, over the shoulder. Over that shoulder.
Oh, yeah.
Two shots.
Christina, can I grab you real quick? I know you're a huge boxing fan. I've seen you at Andre Ward's fights.
Yes, I love boxing.
Break it down. Manny Pacquiao, Floyd Mayweather.
Man, I want to see that fight. See, I'm...
You're hilarious.
Yes, I'm a fan of boxing. I'm not going to say who I'm going for, but I really hope it happens.
Why do you love boxing? What is it about the sport?
I grew up watching boxing. My grandfather was a famous boxer in Cuba, and so my dad used to teach us how to box. So, like, he had nothing but girls, three girls, and all three of us know how to fight.
So if you had to do a charity boxing event for charity, well, all the money, who would you want to box in the celebrity?
Oh my gosh, if I had to box someone?
Yeah.
Ooh, just because I want to, no.
Yes, yes.
Box. Now I'm thinking of something really bad. I'm like 30.
Why not? Who would it be?
It would be my sister Lizzie.
You guys have a new show, right?
You and I in the ring.
What?
You and I.
Who wins?
Who would win in a boxing match?
Ooh, you know what? We've put hands on each other before.
Actually, I have a scar in my nose.
Eat your hand. Who, me?
So, what do you wish Manny Pacquiao tonight? He has a big
good
event.
Luck. This is cool. This is a really cool event. We love anything that supports boxing.
Talking about your show that just came out, and your sister, you said, watch out for her.
Yeah, turned up. Yeah, we're on a new show. New show, Christina Milian, turned up on E!
No, he looks like a narco right now. Maybe like...
When he's not here, he plays in a band. So he plays accordion.
Russell Peters.
His new album's called Alfred, The World Accordion to Alfred.
You just spent an entire hour with Manny Pacquiao. What was that experience like for you as a boxing fan?
As a boxing fan, I was really geeked out by it. And I was like right beside him, you know what I mean? So I was beside myself and beside Manny Pacquiao.
He's a great dude, a lot of charisma, he knows his boxing.
He does. He doesn't like to talk much. He's very political answers. They're safe answers. I like that WBC hat. It looks corrupted.
I'll give it to you.
Come on.
I'll give it to you before we go.
You lost a lot of weight, Ellie. You okay?
Yeah, I gained actually, man.
Yeah, buddy, you look in shape.
I appreciate it. Working too much.
Anybody come see it? I know Manny. Love the guy, so came out to check it out.
You've always been a big Manny fan for years. Every time I interviewed you years ago, why? Why do you love Manny so much?
He comes out to fight. He shows up to fight. Goes after people, so it's fun to watch.
What do you think about the Mayweather-Pacquiao fight?
I would love to see him.
Yeah. Pacquiao or Mayweather?
Come on now. Really? Really. Mayweather.
I'm here tonight.
What do you think about Manny Pacquiao?
I love him. Pac-Man is my favorite boxer. My grandfather was a boxer, so I grew up watching boxing, and he's the best.
What happens when he fights Floyd Mayweather May 2nd?
Oh, boy. I think he's going to easily beat Floyd Mayweather.
fighters home.
I gotta tell you, you gotta come to the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard, the home of my Dana, Brandon Rios, Mikey Garcia. You know why?
I'll be there.
Because Danny, every other person that walks in, I say, hey, what's up, Machete? and we think about you all the time.
Thank
over
you.
There.
I'll be there.
What would you tell Robert Garcia? He just did a great job with my Dana against Mayweather.
He's awesome. Robert, you know what? We love you, man. It's like, Mayweather's a hard, hard person to beat, man. And probably one of your guys are going to do it eventually. You know what I mean?
All day.
What? Of course, Mayweather.
Of course. Come on now.
You haven't seen?
No-brainer.
Hey, Pacquiao Mayweather, break it down.
I think Mayweather, you know what I'm saying, is the best pound for pound.
You know,
and I just got to respect him because he's a money man.
He is a legend. He's a legend.
Manny?
Yeah.
What is it?
Salamat sa iyo, aking Panginoong Jesus. Ako inibig mo at
inamin mo
ang tanging alay ko sa'yo aking ama. Ang buong buhay ko puso't kaluluwa. Di ko makayanang maipagkaloob. Mamahaling hiyas ni Gintong Sinukum. That is the song for Manny.
Okay, and publish this. I'm sorry. Okay, here we go. Shuntel, straight ahead, please. Right here in the front. Straight ahead, Shuntel, right here.
Shuntel,
straight ahead, please.
I'm a huge boxing fan. I actually used to work for a boxing company in Arizona, and so I used to work for HBO, and I hired the ring girls, and like I've always been a huge boxing fan.
What do you think about Manny Pacquiao?
He's amazing. He puts on a really good show. He's humble. He's a hard worker, and he's not too showy and over the top like a lot of people.
Right here, please.
May 2nd, if he fights Floyd Money Mayweather, what can we expect?
One hell of a fight. Like, it's gonna be worth it.
And what are you doing these days?
I'm a FHM and Maxa model, and I just got signed with a new TV show.
Why do you guys love boxing?
Because it's two guys beating the crap out of each other. It's as barbaric as it gets. And I mean, my dad and I watched boxing growing up. I love it. I love boxing.
Mayweather Pacquiao, who wins?
I'm excited. I say Mayweather. I agree.
Why?
He's the best.
47-0.
Exactly.
So what would you tell Floyd if he's watching?
I just took him in the diamond store in New York actually like 2 weeks ago. So I'd say he'd buy a couple more diamond chains.
More diamonds.
He's still in that bike.
And get your calendar.
What? And buy our calendar. Exactly.
I gotta ask you this. What's the latest on tickets? I know, obviously, as a reporter, as a news anchor, you get a lot of the news. What are they saying?
Well, so far, from what I understand, not many tickets are actually going to go on sale. From what I'm hearing, maybe a couple hundred, like 1,000 tickets might go on sale. The rest will go to the promoters, will go to MGM, and
like sponsors, fighters, and their entourage.
Exactly. So maybe about 1,000 tickets will go on sale, and they'll be at maybe $1,000 each, which, I mean, it's a lot of money, but then again, it's more affordable than what I'm hearing, you know, $10,000, $5,000.
Up to 69, I heard, the ringside.
That's crazy. I mean, that is crazy.
But here's the option. Usually you have closed circuit for major fights.
Yes.
What do you think about that? You think the closed circuit will be at $100 or you think it's going to be times two or three?
No, I think it might be times two or
three. It's one of those events?
Yeah, it's one of those events. But at the same time, I think that if you want to be a part of history and be in Vegas, you can't afford, you know, to go buy the tickets or they run out. It's just fun to be there and to be part of the entertainment. Yeah, I think they might be $200, maybe even $300. I don't know, but this is what I'm guessing.
Everything's going to be overpriced. It's going to be airport prices.
It's going to be an expensive trip, just put it that way. Start saving now.
But an experience of a lifetime.
Absolutely.
What about sparring partners? What have you heard? Who's going to spar who for this fight?
Well, isn't Chop Chop sparring with Mayweather? Didn't he tweet you?
He just tweeted me yesterday.
So
he did. I don't know. He just, thanks, Chop Chop, for the shout out. But yeah, he tweeted me, Ellie, I'm going to camp.
That's right. I saw that.
Because you know why he tweeted me? Because I saw him back in December. And he trained a few days in Mayweather's gym. And I said, Chop Chop, when Mayweather fights Pacquiao, you're going to spar him. And he just smiled. And now it happened.
It's happening, yeah.
It's a great opportunity for him. What about Pacquiao? What are you hearing about people sparring him?
I'm thinking it might be Steve Forbes, not confirmed, but that just totally makes sense, don't you think?
Yeah, everybody uses Steve Forbes. Like, right now, John Molina is fighting Adrian Broner, who has a similar style of Floyd.
Mm-hmm.
And Steve Forbes grew up with the Mayweathers, and he grew up with Mayweather Sr.
was
his trainer.
Right?
Exactly. Who better?
Mm-hmm.
Let me ask you this. Manny Pacquiao wore a t-shirt of a Pac-Man eating a dollar sign.
Okay.
I got a t-shirt in the mail from the company of the money sign bigger than a Pac-Man. What do you think about the war of the shirts? Because there's a war of the words, the war in the ring.
You know what? At the end of the day, it's all going to come down to that one day on May 2nd, and we'll see who's actually going to win.
Stella, for all the people who want to follow you on Twitter and Instagram, all the boxing fans, what do you tell them?
Follow me at Stella Inger. You can follow me on Instagram or Twitter. And I also want to give a shout out to all the Manny Pacquiao fans who've already followed me, who sent me messages. You guys know that I'm a huge Manny Pacquiao fan. So yeah, follow me, Instagram, Twitter, and I'm always getting new information. So if you need it, you know, that's the place to go.
Manny Pacquiao's watching this. What do you tell him?
I want to tell him that so many fans have been waiting for this day for so many years. You can do this. You can make this happen, and I know he will. I just know he will.
So there you have it. Anything else you want to add, Stella, about the boxing? Why are you a boxing fan? What got you into the sport?
You know what? I just grew up around it for so many years. My uncles, being born in Russia, my uncles were Greco-Roman wrestlers. Olympians, yeah. One of my uncles was part of the Russian Olympic team. So it was one of those things where I grew up around it, my family watching boxing. So I'm just a huge boxing fan.
Why Pacquiao fan? What got you? What is it about Manny? Is it?
You know what? I just love him as a person. At the end of the day, he's such a humble man. I love the fact that he's so close to God, and he just seems like such an amazing person. And humility. I really, really, really do think that's important in a person.
There you have it, Stella Inger. You can follow her on Twitter and Instagram at Stella Inger. Stay tuned right here talking about Mayweather Pacquiao at LAX. FusionReport.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. And on Instagram at Ellie Secback.